Students, today we're going to see what is need of DC biasing in amplifier. DC biasing means applying external battery to a device in order to get stabilized cue point at the middle of the load line, that is center of the load line. What is need of that? That we need to identify. Hence, we will see the example of common emitter amplifier. This circuit diagram consists of common emitter amplifier in which RC is load for DC, whereas RL is a load for AC analysis. So analysis of this circuit can be classified as DC analysis, that is part 1, and AC analysis, that is part 2. In DC analysis, we will get a graph of line called as DC load line, which consists of all possible combinations of IC and VCE. We know that IC and VCR are my cue points. Now this line will give me idea that where my cue point should be on DC load line or in active region. For that, we need to apply KVL to the output loop. So we'll do that. In DC analysis, the DC equivalent circuit can be obtained by opening the capacitors. There are two capacitors are available in the circuit, CC1 and CC2. We will open these capacitors so that circuit will remain like this. Okay, so first step is open all the capacitors. We can do this because we know that XC, that is reactance of capacitance, is given as 1 upon 2 pi F into C. But for DC, since for DC F is equal to 0, hence XC becomes infinite, and then capacitors are open circuited. Now, after opening the capacitors, circuit diagram will look like this. We will start with the VCC, then we'll have the RC, then we'll have the transistor, common emitter amplifier, and then emitter. Whereas, we'll be having DC supply called as VCC. To input to this, we will be having a base resistor RB along with a base battery VBB. Now we will mark all the resistors. This resistor at the collector is called as RC, whereas resistor at the base is called as RB. The battery applied at the base is called as VBB. Now we will apply KVL to the output loop. Output loop is from collector to emitter, whereas from the collector, the current is flowing called as IC. In order to obtain DC load line, we will apply KVL to the output loop. By applying the KVL to output loop, we will get equation as VCC minus IC into RC minus VCE is equal to 0, because voltage between collector to emitter is called as VCE. Hence, we will keep current on the one side, remaining all parameters on the right hand side, so that equation will become, we can rewrite the equation, IC is equal to multiplied by RC minus VCE plus VCC. Hence, IC is equal to minus 1 by RC into VCE plus 1 by RC into VCC. We know that Q point of a circuit is nothing but IC and VCE. In order to get a line, we require to have minimum 2 points so that we can draw a line. In order to draw DC line, I require 2 points. One is IC and second is VCE. So what we're going to do is case 1. In order to get IC, we will put VCE is equal to 0. Hence, put VCE is equal to 0, so that IC becomes VCC divided by RC. This is point A. Case 2, in order to get VCE, we will put IC is equal to 0. When IC is equal to 0, VCE will become so we are having two equations now, two equations of the points from which we can draw a DC load line. We are having two points, point A and B, through which a DC load line can be passed. So we are going to draw that line now. We will first mark the coordinates of this particular axis. On the y axis, we have taken IC, whereas on the x axis, we have taken VCC. Or simply we can write VCE so that it will become output characteristics of transistor, which consists of graph of output current versus output voltage. Now we are having two points, point A and point B. Point A is nothing but current IC whose value is given as, point A is nothing but current IC whose value is given as VCC by RC, whereas current B is nothing but VCE is equal to VCC. So I will mark two points. So this is point 1, this is point A, and this is point B. For point A, value of IC is nothing but VCC divided by RC, whereas for point B, value of VCE is equal to VCC. We will join these two points, and this line is called as DC load line. This line is called as DC load line. Now, in order to get Q point exactly at the middle of the load line, we need to draw output characteristics when IB is constant. So what we are going to do is, we will select this as Q point and we will draw output characteristics when IB is constant. Now, I will draw perpendiculars on both the axes. And these two sides are identical to each other. And this is our Q point having value VCE at Q point and IC at Q point. So we have selected Q point exactly at the middle of the load line. But it is very important that this Q point should remain at the middle of the load line. That means we are having two different tasks. First task is to get Q point at the middle of the load line, and the second task is to stabilize that Q point at that particular position so that we will get perfect amplified output. Friends, now our aim is to draw a DC load line, where DC load line represents a graph of various values of IC and VCE. And the second aim is that to obtain Q point exactly at the middle of the load line. To draw a line, we require minimum two points. Now, from this equation, we have got two coordinates. Coordinate A, which will give you IC, whereas coordinate B will give you VCE. So DC load line is normally drawn on the output characteristics of common emitter amplifier. For that, the graph of IC versus VCE is called as output characteristics. In that output characteristics, we will draw a DC load line with the help of point A and point B. So we will draw first axis, Y axis, which consists of collector current IC. And then we will draw X axis, which consists of collector to emitter voltage VCE. Point A can be marked on the IC at the value of VCC divided by RC, whereas point B can be marked on VCE at the value of VCC. We will draw a DC load line. passing from A and B. Now, our aim is that to obtain Q point at the center of the load line. Center of the load line means somewhere here. The reason behind this is, if we get Q point at the center of the load line, then amplification during positive half cycle and negative half cycle will remain same and the waveform will be identical. Hence, Q point must be at the center of the load line. This can be drawn with the help of base current IB on output characteristics. So this is base current IB, whereas line passing from A and B is called as DC load line. And this point of intersection is called as Q point. Now, if you draw perpendicular on VCE and IC, we will get that these two points are exactly identical. These two lengths of the lines are exactly identical. Now, this is VCEQ, whereas this point is your ICQ, where ICQ and VCEQ are called as Q point. So Q point is nothing but VCEQ, comma ICQ. This will complete our DC load line. We have obtained Q point exactly at the center of the load line. Thank you.